Joining me now is South Carolina Congressman Trey Gowdy, who sits on both the Judiciary and the House Oversight Committees and is himself a former federal prosecutor, United States attorney, and district attorney. It's good to see you, Congressman. Thanks for being with us.
Good to see you, Judge. Thank you for having me.
My pleasure. Congressman, what should happen to Eric Holder?
You know, Judge, when I was listening to your opening statement, I found myself sitting here not as a congressman, but as a former prosecutor with this overarching sense of sadness that the Department of Justice that you so aptly described as a citadel of justice, represented by a lady who wears nothing but a blindfold, has been politicized and is the subject of ridicule and scorn and a lack of confidence. And then I think of the top law enforcement official in the country. And there are discussions of criminal conduct, and he's become nothing, in my judgment, but a political tool. He's not a prosecutor. He's a political sycophant for the progressive movement. And it is sad. Politics aside, it is sad. I wanted him gone a year ago. But Judge, we had a chance in November, and apparently I failed to persuade enough of our fellow citizens that we need a new top prosecutor.
Congressman, you have experience with this attorney general in your role on the House Oversight Fast and Furious. You guys held him in contempt, not just Republicans, but Democrats as well. And now we've got another scandal, another scandal. What do you say to people who say, oh, this is nothing but politics? I mean, you know, you have honor for the Department of Justice. I do. I'm in awe of the Department of Justice. And now it's become, as you say, you know, it's almost a political operative. Am I wrong?
No, you are. And when people say it's political, I point them to the U.S. attorney in South Carolina, who is to the left of Chairman Mao politically. He's to the left of Eric Holder. But he's doing a phenomenal job because he doesn't politicize the office of United States attorney in South Carolina. He doesn't believe in the death penalty, so he doesn't participate in the decision-making. But he doesn't try to legislate, and he doesn't try to enforce a progressive agenda. And that's my frustration with this attorney general. He sues states when it's politically advantageous to him to sue them. He talks about immigration and the ability to break our immigration laws as a civil and human right,
but you
which
know
is the last thing I ask him about.
Congressman, but you know what you're talking about now, and I happen to agree with you, those are, as you say, those are somewhat political issues. And as you and I both know, we're not supposed to be political in a position as a chief law enforcement officer, but it's worse than that. The guy is lying to Congress. He's arguing executive privilege when you guys get too close to things. He doesn't answer. He is dilatory in his responses. And now it appears that he lied on May 15th in front of the House Judiciary.
Well, you know, Judge, when you are asked about an ongoing investigation, the proper response is no comment. If you feel compelled to respond, you need to respond accurately. And Chairman Goodlatte and Chairman Sensenbrenner have written the Attorney General, which itself is sad, that the Chairman of House Judiciary has had to write the Attorney General and ask him to clarify what appears to certainly be false, misleading testimony before a committee of Congress. And then the naming of a reporter as an aider and abettor and a co-conspirator, both of which are criminal charges. But yet, you don't indict him, so you don't give him a forum to clear his name. You just malign him in an affidavit in support of a search warrant, and you walk away.
Okay, I've got a heart out. It's so true. 6E, I mean, you know it. You don't do that. Congressman Gowdy, it's always good to have you on the show. Thanks for being with us.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
You're welcome.